Tradition. So I'll start with two or three quotations. First one is, give and you will receive. Give and it will be given to you.
Yes.
Or any words you can use. If you give and it will be given to you, give. And the measure in which you give will be the measure in which you will receive.
Yes.
This is said by whom? It is there in the Bible.
Bible.
In the Bible. Okay. So it means what? That you give and don't bother about it. It will come back to you in some form or the other.
The more you give, the more you get.
Yeah, that is. Then our friend Sri Ravi Shankar, he says, success and happiness both are dependent on giving. Success and happiness both are dependent on giving. This ability of giving is in your mind, in your consciousness, and it is not the object that you give that matters. So what you give does not matter. It is what. The principle or the
the
attitude of giving. The attitude of sharing is what is important. The attitude of sharing is what it is. So you have Bible, you have Ravi Shankar saying this. Now third quotation is, you will not attain piety. You will not attain piety until you give, you expand what you love. You will not get receive piety. Okay, you will not attain piety. Going to piety means a deep state of religiousness, spirituality. You see? So attaining means you have to work towards it. So you will not attain the piety unless or until you expand. Expand means to use up resources, give it. Unless you expand your resource, your unless you expand what you love, and whatever you expand, God knows about it. This is given in the Quran. Okay, and see how beautiful it is. Expand what you love. That means what you want, what you like. If you share that with somebody, give it. That is called giving. See, now for the last 3 days, I'm doing a lot of cleaning of the house, whatever you call it, you know. So I've thrown hundreds of papers, lakhs, thousands of papers. Stone, cardboard things, etc. So many things. And I'm giving it also. I'm not giving. But that is not giving. That is only getting rid of the kachra in your life. But what you give is important. You give something which you like. Which then it is really giving. Otherwise, every morning we go to the bathroom and leave behind something. That is only getting rid of our dirt. So what I've done in the last 3 days is got rid of my dirt to make my house clean. To look better. So that is not giving. So if you expand what you love, and God knows about it. So these three quotations bring out very powerfully the principle or the law of giving. Okay. Above quotations very forcefully give the importance of the law of giving. You know, one of the best known writers, current day writers, and most respected is Deepak Chopra. You must have read or heard about him or read his books or seen his books. One of the books he has written is entitled The Seven Spiritual Laws of Success. Seven Spiritual Laws of Success. In that, Deepak Chopra has included the law of giving as one of the spiritual laws. One of the spiritual laws are the law of giving. Okay. So, what is giving? Giving is a beautiful experience. Okay, by practicing giving, you make a difference to yourself and to others. Your life is never the same once you start giving. Once you give, of course you make a difference to others because you give them something valuable, but you make a difference to yourself also. So giving helps, it makes you a difference. Giving helps to avoid or overcome loneliness. Your loneliness also can be overcome. If you give means you are sharing, you're bringing people into your life, okay. It helps you to live to your potential and many things will tell. So giving is, Aziz Jamal is the writer, Azim, A-Z-I-M. It's a letter, writer well known from the Middle East. Azim Jamal says, the more you are in the flow of giving, the more abundance will flow through you. The more you are in the flow of giving, the more abundance will flow through you. Okay. Now again, Deepak Chopra. According to Deepak Chopra, practicing the law of giving is very simple. It's not complicated like your contract act and all that. It is very, very simple. Give what you want in life, you give to, and you will get. So what does he say? He said, it is very simple giving. If you want joy in life, give joy to others. If you want love in life, give it to others. If you want respect and attention, you give that. If you want material affluence, help others to become material affluent. Give, so, so this is what he says, that, so he says the best way to get what you want in life is to help enough other people to get what they want in life, okay? Zig Ziglar says the same thing. You can get anything you want, provided you help enough people to get what they want. And that well-known thinker, Emerson, what he says? It is one of the beautiful compensation of life is that you cannot help others without helping yourself. Yes. So these are all the thinkers on giving, okay? Now, what about the law of giving? Okay. According to Skip Ross, now there are three principles. There may be more, but I know of three principles which are given by Skip Ross and the other. According to Skip Ross, the first principle on which the law of giving is based is give and you will receive. Okay. Now this principle is expressed in different words. Give and you will receive. It's called the law of action and reaction. Like Newton said, action and reaction are equal. It's called law of action and reaction.
Cause
and effect. Very good, excellent. What else? Anything else? Radiation and attention. And cause and effect. Law of sowing and reaping. What you sow is what you you plant corn, you'll get corn. You plant onions, you'll get onions. You plant love, you'll get love. Okay. So this is what you are required to do. Because what you plant is what you get. It comes back to you. Okay. That is the first principle on which the law of giving is based. Okay. Now some smart people, you know, will argue, when I have nothing to give myself, what can I give to others? I myself don't have enough. What can I
say?
So you say that. Then the second principle is of this law of giving is that you always have something to give. You don't have need to have money to give. Now, for example, when you came, Mr. Shyam. Now, when you came, I remember you came and gave me a small bottle of oil. But this is giving. Yes. He could have come with a flower. So next time you come in my class, you bring some flour, bring a Cadbury chocolate.
Or
Exactly. Yeah. So what are the things you can give? Simple. A smile. Warm smile. A warm handshake.
Gesture.
Yeah. A pat on the back. Now depending on your cultural this thing, some people give a hug, some people give a handshake. Okay. Then what else you can give? Respect.
Smile,
yeah, very good. Smile is a beautiful gift you can give.
Not single penny you want to pay.
Not, what else can you give? Come on, tell me. What else can you give?
A good word.
An encouraging word. A compliment. You're looking nice. It doesn't cost you anything. So you can give anything. Another one thing you can give, a beautiful thing you can give is touch. Touch is very important. Basic human need, touch is basic. Now I won't tell you more about touch because you will go and touch people and then this will, every day in the paper we are getting the, That's why they use the word inappropriate touch. Don't touch inappropriately. Now touch will depend on a relationship. A mother kissing a child is most acceptable.
Okay.
And it also depends on the cultural this thing, no? Touching also. In our country, most of us are very gender conscious. We are, no? We at the most shake hands with a woman, with a person. But now people are thinking in the corporate world to ban this, you know, to make it an illegal act, because people, but if you go to a Western country, it is very common. Yeah, hugging somebody, kissing on the cheek, etc., is a way of greeting. Yeah. Whereas if you go to a Muslim this thing, they will do just this one. Nobody will touch. Man will kiss each other. That is permissible there. Yeah. But women will not even talk to you. Both. Yeah. But keeping we are intelligent enough to know what we can do. But touch is very important. Yeah. And especially if it's for a child and all that, not just a pat on the back. For you it will be nothing, but for him it will be a lot. He can build up his whole life. So these are some of the things you can give attention. You know, one point of attention which we all can learn is listening, active listening. When somebody is talking, you keep quiet and listen to him. This is the way you give respect also. You see? And the person feels nice that it is what you consider what he is speaking is important. So you keep quiet and listen to him properly, pay attention. Okay. What else can you do? We can praise people. Never miss an opportunity to praise people. Because we are built by praise. Human being is built by praise. And destroyed by criticism. In fun also, don't criticize anybody. You are harming that person. If you criticize that person, you are harming that person.
If I criticize somebody, I'm harming myself.
You are harming yourself, you are harming somebody else. No? That is what I'm saying. So take care. So you can do this. So you respect to all people regardless of their social status. That is, don't only bow down or respect your boss. All persons, irrespective of status, age, gender, position in life, intelligence, whatever it is. You know, this man is very intelligent and he's a PhD. I give him respect for that, and he's only a BSc. I give him respect because he's a human being. Can you remember one thing? That's what I feel is that every human being deserves to be respected because he's a human being. Everything else is afterwards, you see. Every human being is. Don't take extreme cases of drunkards coming and all that. But generally, people you meet in life, you can learn to give them respect. Okay, right. Now, what is the third principle then? Now, third principle says that you give and give and give all over again. You see, you give all over again without knowing when and how it will come back to you. Without knowing when and how it will come back to you. But you continue giving and it will come back from somewhere. And when it comes back, when the reward comes back to you, what will you do? Reject it?
Accept
it. Yes. That's right. Gracefully accept it, because the law of giving is what?
Law of receiving also.
Both. The law of, to receive the... Both giving and receiving are two sides of the same coin. Many people are not able to receive things, you know, they feel something. I am so big, why should I take from you? This is coming back to you, you take it, because that is part of the law. The whole process is complete when giving and receiving is done. Okay. So these are the three principles of which on which the law of giving is based. Anything you want to say?
Appreciation, it is called as
well. Appreciation, yeah, you can give appreciation to people. So don't forget to appreciate me after the lecture. आप कुछ बोलना चाहोगे?
नहीं.
आप बोलिए बोलिए. You can contribute. Or you will have. Okay, now we go to one. Two. Now this so far the principle that we have enumerated about the law of giving, it operates powerfully in every area of our life. Okay, every area of our life. Now, what are the benefits of giving?
Fulfillment.
Fulfillment. Yeah. One thing is, you mind, this is a part of the series of developing a winning personality. And one of the first things I told about that is, learn to unlock your potential. So, this law of giving, practicing giving, helps you to unlock your potential. Okay, that is. it makes you fearless. That's very important. It makes you fearless. Yeah. You give. You know, it will come. You give, you help. You see. It's also very, very socialistic giving, you know. Very, very socialistic. The gap that is there between people, it gets reduced when you learn to give. Okay, the disparity which is there between people, somebody having crores of rupees and somebody not even having a few pennies. Okay, so it makes you fearless. You overcome loneliness. Yeah. Or the first thing is you avoid, or you overcome loneliness. Then you said fulfillment, that was correct. You find meaning and fulfillment in your life. There's something you're doing, see. The very thought that you're giving something, you have made a commitment to give, brings a lot of radiance into your life, okay? The more abundance flow, you have done that. You learn to develop new relationship. When you give, you develop new relationship, and then you build a feeling of security in the mind of the giver. The giver feels quite secure that everything is okay. Don't, the third law is there, the second law is there, it will follow, okay? And it generally results in good health, peace of mind, love, etc. And very importantly, it reduces self-centeredness. Otherwise, we are all very self-centered. What we are bothered only about how it affects us, what we want, what we don't. But here you know, learn that there are other human beings also. So it reduces self, it don't eliminate completely, because human beings are human beings, but yeah, it reduces self-centeredness. Okay. What are the moral reasons for giving? Now we are coming to the ethical part. Why should I give? Why is it almost, even no law makes it, nobody forces you. But if you are a clean, good human being, you will feel that you are bound to give. Why? Can you tell me?
You cannot see the suffering of another man. One has to look at it as a suffering of oneself.
Okay. What else?
Nature has given us everything.
That's right.
Yes. Our liabilities.
Yeah, exactly. That is what it is.
To balance our life's needs.
Yeah, that's right. Okay.
Love farming.
Okay, that's great. No man is an island.
No man is an island.
No man is, what do we say, totally independent of it. Nobody is totally independent. We are interdependent. And this is not for today or yesterday or tomorrow. It is throughout your life. See how you were born. You were born because of the physical activity of two other persons. You may call them mummy, daddy and all, but the fact is, it is their physical activity that you were born. And from the time you were conceived, till today you are 79 years old, you have been receiving from society, from universe, from the hospitals that took care of you, from your teachers, from your elders, from your parents, from your siblings, from your neighbors, from your friends, from your professors, from your teachers, from speakers like me.
Audience like me.
Audience like you. We are receiving. This. And then, you know, somebody was there and said, I'm independent. I just now, what is that? I've come to Tardev to help library. I've spent, paid 200 rupees in a taxi and I got in and paid. What is there? Who made the taxi? You made the taxi? Who made the road? You made the road? Who made that lift from which you have come? Who made the car by which you came? So, we are dependent. Even if you have lots of money, you can't do anything.
Synergistic interdependence.
Yes. Okay. So, this is the moral. So, the reason is that you have received so much from society, from the universe.
So much.
You have received so much from the society, from the universe. It behoves you to give back to the society. You have not only received, you continue receiving.
You continue to
now also, whether I go in a Ola cab or Uber cab or BST bus, I'm dependent on somebody. If I walk, I'm dependent. Bata makes the shoe. I don't make the shoe. I can only give him 50 rupees, 100 rupees, 900 rupees, whatever he wants, and wear the shoe. But he makes the shoe. So somebody makes the road, I may curse him. No, the road. But if there was no road, what would I do? There was jungle, there would be leopards. Okay, so the moral reason for giving is this, that we have been receiving so much and so much more, and we continue receiving it. Even when you die, somebody else will bury us and do things, okay. So, as he put it, actually the circuit is there. We are not independent. Yeah, we are not independent. We are all interdependent. Okay. So, that is the moral reasoning for giving up. If I come to your house four times, you will feel, no, he's coming to my house, he's not calling me to his house. You see. So, how you feel? It hits you, no? It's like that with the universe also. The universe is giving so much and you don't want to give anything. You just want to take and take and take.
It's called
greediness. Greediness, selfishness, self-centeredness, all this is, all it is interlinked, okay? To give more credence to whatever we are saying is that almost all religions, but I don't want to take religion from the point of view of people fighting here, but religion is showing the way how to live, if you believe, or
showing the path of living.
The spirituality that is there in that.
Showing the path of living.
Yeah. We'll take up this point only. Almost all such religions, such isms, such ways of thinking, they all encourage generosity and giving. And they do it very, very clearly. For example, Christianity tells you that one tenth of your, they've got a principle called tithing. That is, one tenth of your income is for charity. Wait, yeah, I will come to that. Now, wait, what I want to emphasize is that one tenth is. So Christianity says that principle of tithing, that one tenth of your income is to be given to the poor. Now kindly remember, it says one tenth of the income is, you don't decide. It's a TDS. Today also I got a letter from the bank saying that so much TDS has been deducted. I don't even see that money. That money straight away goes to the government. So that way one tenth of your income is for charity. Islam has the similar way, they have the principle of zakat, where they say that certain amount of your money, percentage of your money belongs to the poor. Some 2.5% of your, actually in 40 years the whole thing is gone. 100% is gone, no, 2.5%, something like that. So we are not getting into the complicated calculation and all, but they are emphasizing charity. They are emphasizing giving. Judaism also same thing. They got what, I'll tell you the word, Zedaka. And I don't know how to pronounce it. It starts with T. T-Z-E. T-Z-E-D-A-K-A-H. So they also have this thing. And Hinduism also, generosity is praised and perceived as a way to bliss and heaven, okay. So we can say that every major schools of thinking, they emphasize charity
and giving.
Okay.
Hinduism says, anybody coming, khali haath gela hai bhai. You should not go empty-handed.
Okay, yeah.
And the biggest act of this giving was karna.
Right. So finally, what does it mean? If you follow all this thing, it means if only everyone gave a little more, the world would be a more peaceful and beautiful place. Okay, that is what it is, more just, more fair, more peaceful. Now we'll look at giving from another perspective. You see. We need to give up certain things in order to achieve peace of mind, success, etc. What I mean is, you give up certain bad habits. Law of giving includes giving up bad habits. Okay. So bad habits like excessive sleeping, excessive smoking, excessive talking, drinking, drugs.
Any kind of addiction?
Addictions, yeah, drugs, drinking, etc. Laziness, procrastination, All these habits reduce your capacity to prosper, to achieve your goals, etc. Okay. So we have to learn to give up these habits. Now, because a human being is a creature of habits. First we make the habit, then habits make us, and then they unmake us also, because habits can be productive or unproductive. This which I mentioned to you are all unproductive habits. Excessive watching of TV. बैठके देखते हैं रेगा पांच घंटा उन लोगों को पैसा मिलता है ना खेलने के लिए IPL instead of doing a work or listening to some songs or just sitting in front of the TV and whatever is going on you keep on listening. और कुछ बोलने I would say excessive talking also is a waste of time. Anyway, all these are bad habits. You can decide for yourself which are your bad habits. But one thing is certain, that these unproductive habits are a big obstacle to our growth. If you take care of these bad habits, you will free time for your development, personal development. You see? Okay. Now, we need not think only of physical habits which are bad. There are certain mental habits also which are very bad. Can you name some? Mental habits.
Judging others.
Yeah, okay. Yes. Being judgmental will be a mental. Then, backbiting. Talking. What else?
Debilitating anyone.
Okay. What about worrying? The habit of worrying.
Worrying.
It's a mental habit.
Mental.
Which is a very one of the most dangerous. Mental habits, okay. Then?
Comparison.
Saying yes when you want to say no. In fact, then trying to be in the good books of everybody.
Approval.
Seeking approval from everybody. Yeah. Okay. Another mental habit which I think all of us suffer, this man doesn't suffer, he must have broken free from that, is the habit of carrying limiting beliefs. This I can't do, this is not meant for me, I was not meant for this. Arey, ye toh kya kaam kar sakta? This is meant for...
mental block, right?
Yeah. Okay, this is meant for other people, not for me. I can never become rich, I can never become successful. Whatever it is, limiting beliefs, you limit yourself. That is a mental habit. Okay. So what all we have covered? What is law of giving? What are the benefits of law of giving? What do people say about law of giving? What will you get if you practice the law of giving? Okay. So shall we stop here? Yeah.
You can still give more.
No, we'll stop here. So before we go from here, we'll make a decision. I want that from you. Make a decision. Now you all agree, giving is very beautiful. You can make a difference to yourself and to others. Okay. And there are two words I'm going to use. Giving is empowering. It empowers you. And it is liberating. It makes you free from fear, etc. So that's very important. Okay. So make a decision that from today, that any time you meet a new person, you'll give him something. It can be a word of praise, it can be a compliment, it can be a flower, whatever it is. Okay. It can be a word of praise. You know, very often, if I hear something good about you, I keep it to myself. I should tell it to him. That is also giving. Learning that I will listen to people, active listening, I will not interrupt, I'll listen without interruption, without judgment. Now that would be great way of giving, showing respect, etc. Okay, so are you making that decision?
Yeah.
Okay, that's great. So, last I'll say, giving is a beautiful experience, you can make a difference to yourself and to others. If you practice giving regularly, giving is empowering, giving is liberating. Okay. Make a decision to go wherever you go, whomsoever you meet. Okay. Abhi jayega, the liftman will be there. If you see something nice about him, no, he may be energetic, he may be smiling well. See, once if you start looking for good things, you'll find. You'll find everywhere good things. If you want to look for bad things because you want to criticize, you want to complain, etc., then you'll find that. Okay. So you make a decision today that you'll see something good and give it to people. Okay. Right. Thank you.
Thank you. So,